ओम ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाखया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सरस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। सो हियर वी आर सीइंग द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ the appearance of the Supreme Lord as Lord Kapila. So we saw that how the Supreme Lord entered through the simen of Kardama Muni into the womb of Devahuti. And at that time, because when the Supreme Lord appears, then practically all kind of auspiciousness appears with the Lord. Just like when an important person comes, then all other subordinate, they give a very warm welcome reception to that important person. They make all kind of arrangements. So similarly, we see here when the Supreme Lord appeared, it is said here that the demigods in the form of raining clouds sounded musical instruments. Gandharvas, the celestial singers, they all started singing the glories of the Lord. And the Apsaras, the celestial dancers, they all started joyfully dancing to celebrate the appearance of the Lord. Then, at the time of Lord's appearance, the devatas, they all came to the sky, because it is said that specially in Siddha Loka, the living entities, they are not hampered from going from one planet to another. When we have to go from one planet to another, we have to satisfy so many conditions, and we cannot go just like that. We require some kind of arrangements. But without being hampered, the residents of Siddha Loka, they can travel from one place to another. That is stated in the Vedic literature, because they have achieved that kind of perfection. So they all appeared in the sky and showered flowers on the occasion of appearance of the Supreme Lord. And by the appearance of the Supreme Lord, all the directions, the water, everything, even the minds of every living entity became very, very peaceful. At that time, Brahma, who is also called as the firstborn living entities in this universe, along with Marichi and other sages, they all went to the hermitage of Kardama Muni, and there Brahma could actually understand that it is the Supreme Lord Krishna, his amsha, kala or amsha, portion, plenary portion of the Lord, he has appeared in the womb of Devahuti. So this is the description which we are reading. Bhagavantam param brahma satvena amshena shatruhan तत्व सांख्याना विज्ञापय जातम विद्वान अजह स्वराट भगवंतम परम ब्रह्मा हु हैज अपियर्ड द सुप्रीम पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉड हेड भगवंतम हु इज परम ब्रह्मा दैट इज द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड कृष्णा हिमसेल्फ सत्वेन He has appeared in his original existence of Shuddha Sattva. How has the Lord appeared? He has appeared by his plenary portion, Amshena. Why has he appeared? What is the mission of the Lord when he has appeared? Tattva Sankhyana Vignapai. The Supreme Lord has appeared to propagate the philosophy of Sankhya. Jatam Vidwan Ajahswarat. All this was immediately understood by Jatam means understood by Vidwan, very learned, Ajaha, unborn, Lord Brahma, Swarat, who's almost independent. He was able to understand this reality. So, there are four very important points which Prabhupada brings out in the purport. Prabhupada explains that actually the compiler of all knowledge is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Bhagavad Gita, Krishna very clearly says, Vedanta Krit, I am the compiler of Vedanta. Vedavit, I am the real knower of the Veda. So that means, Veda actually means knowledge. So the compiler of all the different branches of knowledge, in reality, is the Supreme Personality of Godhead Himself. And the ultimate knowledge, Vedanta, end of knowledge, ultimate knowledge, Krishna says, it is compiled by me, Vedanta Krit, Vedavit, and the real understanding of the Vedas is known to me, Vedavit, I am the knower of the Veda. So, similarly, Prabhupada explains, the propounder, the compiler of Sankhya philosophy is also the Supreme Personality of Godhead. As it is stated here. In this verse, it is very clearly mentioned, the Supreme Lord appeared as son of Kardama and Devahuti, who has appeared, not some ordinary personality, not some ordinary person is going to now propagate this philosophy of Sankhya. No. It is the Amsha, the plenary portion of the Supreme Bhagavantam Param Brahman, plenary portion of Supreme Brahman, Bhagavantam, he has appeared. And he is going to propagate the philosophy of Sankhya. So, in the purport, Prabhupada says, there is one more Kapila, who is also famous as propounder of Sankhya philosophy. But there is a difference between imitation Kapila and original Kapila. Sometimes you find a lot of imitations appear. Imitation Kalki has already appeared. Isn't it? So like that, many imitations of the different incarnations mentioned in the Vedic literatures appear. So Lord Kapila appeared and then later on another Kapila appeared, imitation Kapila. And he imitated the philosophy of Sankhya. trying to propagate the philosophy of Sankhya. But the conclusion of both of these philosophies is completely different. The conclusion of atheistic Sankhya philosophy is, it does not point out to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. It only studies this material creation, the elements of material world, and not reaching the conclusion of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Whereas Prabhupada explains that the real Sankhya philosophy as propounded by Lord Kapila actually not only explains explicitly the whole material creation, how it is created, what are the elements behind them, it also explains about the spiritual creation. Creation in the spiritual world. In today's purport, Prabhupada is explaining that. Kapila, the son of Kardama Muni, in his system of Sankhya philosophy, very explicitly explained not only the material world but also the spiritual world. So, material world, just like Krishna explains body and the soul by differentiating between them, making us to understand clearly what is matter and what is spirit. Antavantu ime deha. Krishna is commenting about this body. What is this body? What is matter? Antavanta. It is going to end one day. And then Krishna is talking about the soul. Na jayate mriyate va kadachin. Like this. So Krishna explained about matter and Krishna explains about spirit in order to establish the knowledge about soul. Similarly, Lord Kapila is explaining about creation of this material world, not explaining it independent of the Supreme Lord, but to establish that actually the Creator, the Supreme Lord, creates both the material world and the spiritual world. So, the difference is, atheistic Kapila's philosophy establishes atheism, whereas Lord Kapila's Sankhya philosophy is actually complete theism. It is not atheism. It establishes the Supreme Personality of Godhead and devotion to the Supreme Personality of God. So, that is one very important point which Prabhupada is explaining in the purport. Another very important point which Prabhupada explains here, and it is required because sometimes what happens, the Supreme Lord, in the right in the beginning, he is called Swarat. Right? In the very first sloka of Bhagavatam, he is called as Swarat. Here we find Lord Brahma is also addressed as Swarat. The Supreme Lord, he is also called Aja, one who has no birth. And here we find Brahma is also called Aja. So sometime we may wonder whether it is the same personality. Probably Brahma only is that Supreme Personality of Godhead. Isn't it? That same Param Brahman, he only appears as Brahma. Of course, sometime the Lord appears as Brahma whenever there is no suitable living entity available. Just like sometimes the Prime Minister himself may take Home Department, he himself may take Foreign Department. When there is no suitable minister available, he may himself take charge. But whenever there is a suitable person available, then that position is given to that suitable person. So similarly, whenever in the universe there is no suitable living entity available, then the Supreme Lord may play the part of Brahma. But otherwise, this position is generally taken by the living entity. So Brahma is actually a living entity. But here, he is called as Aja, he is called as Swarat. So we need to understand it properly so that we don't mistake the same words when it is used for the Supreme Personality of Godhead and when the same word it is used for Brahma. Just like Bhagavatam, sometimes we find Bhagavan, this word is also used sometimes for a great personality, powerful personality, sometimes they are also called as Bhagavan. So depending on the context, we have to understand how these words are being used. So in the previous words, Brahma was called as Swayambhu. That means one who does not require anybody's help to be born. Swayambhu, who appeared himself. What does it mean is, he does not require the help. Like in this material world, there is a male, there is a female, and then the child is born. So Vedic literature explains that while Lakshmiji is still present, the Lord Vishnu, he did not take help of Mother Lakshmi. And from the navel of Lord Vishnu in the form of Garbhodakshai Vishnu, a lotus appeared. And on that lotus, Brahmaji was born. So that is why he is called as Swayambhu, or also called as Aja, unborn. Because his birth is not ordinary, like birth of other living entities. He is directly born from the Supreme Personality of God. So, Swarat, when Brahmaji is called as Swarat, Prabhupada explains, who is almost independent does not mean he is supremely independent. We are also independent to certain extent. We are also controller to certain extent. We are also Ishvara to certain extent. But we are not supremely independent. We have some free will. It is very minute. Brahma's free will, Brahma's independence is greater than every living entity of this universe. So, in that sense it is compared, it is almost, he is called as Swarat. Actually, foolish people of this material world, when they are asked, who is the creator of this material universe? So practically people will point out Brahma. Brahma created this material. Right? That is what we hear. This Brahmanda, it is created by Brahma. So, Narada, in the second canto, we find he wanted to very scientifically establish this fact right directly from Brahmaji himself. He said that many people, including myself, I am thinking that you are very powerful. You are like a spider who creates its own net, does not require any other help. Everything is under your control, just like walnut can be held in a palm, right? You can hold one walnut in a palm. So likewise, it looks like that everything is under your control. But then, at the same time, I see that you are performing severe austerities. So can you please explain? Are you the original creator? Are you completely independent? Same question was asked. Are you completely independent? So very interestingly, I'll just read those verses. Yad vignano, yad adharo, yad parastvam, yad atmakaha, ekah srajasi bhutani, bhuter evatma mayaya. My dear father, what is the source of your knowledge? So first Narada explained how much knowledgeable Brahma is. What the creation of Brahma looks like. He is holding the whole universe, you know, like a person holding walnut in his hand. And then he is giving the example, just like a spider creates its own web and then takes it inside. Looks like there is nobody else. You with your own energy create everything. But then here Narada is asking, my dear father, what is the source of your knowledge? Under whose protection are you standing? Are you independent or somebody else is protecting you? And under whom are you working? Are you independently working or are you working on the order of somebody? Do you create on the order of somebody? Or you create in your own? What is your real position? Do you alone create all entities with material element by your personal energy? Bhutere evatma mayaya. All these living bhutas, all these living entities, do you create by your own atma mayaya? By your own personal energy do you create? And then, next after a few more verses he says, Sabhavan acharad ghoram yat tapaha Shushmahitaha tena khedayase nastvam parasankham chay yachhasi. Yet we are moved to wonder about the existence of someone more powerful than you when we think of your great austerities in perfect discipline. But then I am moved to see that actually you are also performing great austerities to please someone else. Although your good self is so powerful in the matter of creation. So like that he asked and then Brahmaji replied. Yena swa rochisha vishvam rochitam rochyami aham yatha arko agnir yatha somo yatha arkasha griha tarakaha. So very nicely Brahmaji replies. He says, I create after the Lord's creation by his personal effulgence known as Brahma Jyoti. Yena swa rochisa vishvam. After the creation by the Supreme Lord, I create. Rochitam rochyami aham. Later on, secondarily, I create. And then he is giving the example, how is it? How it can be compared? He says, just as when the sun manifests its fire, when the sun becomes lighted, moon, firmament, influential planet, twinkling stars, they all become bright. How they become bright? It is all by the light of sun. Not independently, right? Like that. And in the next verse, he makes it more clear. So in the purport of this, Prabhupada explains, Brahmaji clears up the wrong impression held by less intelligent people. That is the wrong impression which people hold. Brahma is supreme. He is the creator. Independent, Swarat. No. So, Brahmaji in Brahma Samhita also points out, it is not me who creates. He says, Yasya Prabha Prabhavato Jagadanda Koti. All these kotis of Brahmas, Brahmandas and even Brahmas like me, they are born from the Supreme Personality of Godhead. कोटिषु अशेष वसुधादि विभूति भिन्नम तद् ब्रह्म निष्कलम अनंतम अशेष भूतम गोविंदमादि पुरुषम दैट गोविंद आई वर्शिप फ्रॉम हूज bodily effulgence, all these millions of universes are coming out. And then Brahmaji again says, Tasmai namo bhagavate vasudevaya dhimahi. He's clearly saying that Supreme Lord Vasudeva, I worship that bhagavate, yan mayaya, by whose illusory potency Durjayaya Mam Vadati Jagadguru. By his illusory energy, foolish people think, I am that Supreme Master. I am that Jagadguru. I offer my obeisances and meditate upon Lord Krishna, the personality of Godhead, whose invincible potency influences the less intelligent class of men to call me the Supreme Controller. So actually we can see very clearly. So that's why Prabhupada is explaining this. Otherwise, generally, these so-called commentators, you know, they will misuse these words and they will say that yes, there is no difference. Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, Jiva, everything is one. Isn't it? The other day we were seeing that in that debate, you are all hearing about that, right? Everything is one. Another very important point which Prabhupada makes, that we will conclude, is that sattvena amshena, this is very important. So Prabhupada explains there are two, three important understanding of this. Sattvena amshena. Can somebody bring about those points? What are the points which Prabhupada is telling about this? Sattvena amshena. There are three important points which Prabhupada says about sattvena. The Supreme Lord appears in pure goodness. Very good. Shuddha Sattva. Only on that platform the Lord appears. Good. Then Amshena we will see later. Sattvena. Vasudeva platform. Same thing. The Lord appears in Shuddha Sattva or on Vasudeva platform. One more point Prabhupada says is, this also indicates, whenever the Supreme Lord appears, he appears with all his paraphernalia. And all of them are transcendental or in Shuddha Sattva. The Lord brings his all, because the Lord cannot appear in this material circumstances. He has to create spiritual circumstances. His form has to be transcendental. His name has to be transcendental. His pastime has to be transcendental. His shankha, chakra, everything has to be transcendental. Then only the Lord appears. So then when the Lord is appearing in Shuddha Sattva, he brings all his paraphernalia along with him. So it is very important to note. That means wherever the Lord appears, all his paraphernalia also appears. His name, his form, his pastime, everything. And all of them are transcendental. So, this is one very important thing. I'll just read that portion where Prabhupada says. Another important point stated here, sattvena amshena. When the Supreme Personality of Godhead appears, he brings with him all his paraphernalia of Vaikuntha. He brings with him everything. Therefore, and that is why, because the Lord, when he from the spiritual world, he is bringing his name, he is bringing his paraphernalia, everything, he appears with everything. Therefore, his name, his form, his quality, his paraphernalia, his entourage, all belong to the transcendental world. Even his entourage, when Krishna appears with many of his pure devotees to assist the Lord, all his entourage, they all belong to transcendental world. So, what is the difference between the goodness of this material world and the spiritual world is, in this material world, hardly we can find pure goodness, except for pure devotees. They exist in pure goodness. But otherwise, generally in the material world, even the quality of goodness is tinged with passion and ignorance, other lower modes. That is the difference. Vaikuntha or the spiritual world is pure goodness. And even in the material world, when the Lord appears, he appears only in pure goodness, only in those circumstances. So, he appears in the heart of Vasudev, because his heart is in pure goodness. Similarly, if we want the Lord appears before us, then we have to also make our life completely in pure goodness. That is the third point Prabhupada makes. So the Lord appears in pure goodness, the Lord brings all his paraphernalia, and the devotee can see him only when the devotee is in also pure goodness. Then we can see him face to face. Then, because the Lord appears before our eyes in that pure goodness. So, Prabhupada is saying, here in the material world, the quality of goodness is not pure. Goodness may exist, but there must also be some tinges of passion and ignorance. In the spiritual world, unalloyed quality of goodness prevails. There, quality of goodness is called Shuddha Sattva, pure goodness. Another name of Shuddha Sattva is Vasudev, because God is born from Vasudev. Another meaning is, see, this is Prabhupada saying, what is the another meaning? Another meaning is, when one is purely situated in qualities of goodness, he can understand name, form, quality, paraphernalia, entourage of Supreme Lord. Until we come to Shuddha Sattva state, we cannot understand his name, we cannot appreciate his form, we cannot appreciate his qualities, we cannot appreciate the leelas of the Lord. We also need to come to that platform to understand him. And then finally Prabhupada explains about the word Amshena. There are two things, Kala and Amsha. Kala means the direct expansion of something is called Amsha, and expansion of expansion is called Kala. So here, Lord Kapila, he is the plenary portion of the Supreme Lord. That's why he is called as Amsha here. So Prabhupada is explaining that. Word Amshena indicates the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Krishna appeared as Kapila Dev is a portion of his portion. God expands as Kala or as Amsha. Amsha means direct expansion, and Kala means expansion of the expansion. But Prabhupada explains, ultimately there is no difference. It's just like in Brahma Samhita it is explained, one candle or 100th candle. Right? Suppose from one candle you ignite 100 candles. From that second you ignite third, from third you ignite fourth, from fourth you ignite 100, whatever. But practically, in illumination, there is no such difference. But original remains the original. That original is Supreme Personality of Godhead, who expands into varieties of expansions or as incarnations. The Supreme Lord comes in this material world. He is called as cause of all causes. So we'll stop with this. Granthara Srimad Bhagavatam Ki Jai Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada. Yes. Yes, very well. The same thing was explained just previous few verses back. The Lord is independent, and that is why it is explained there very clearly. He took shelter of semen of Kardal. It is up to him. He can take shelter of pillar also. We can ask the same question. How the Lord can appear from pillar? That is also material. Pillar is material, no? If semen is material, pillar is also material. Isn't it? So, the Lord does not appear in anything material. When the Lord appears, everything is completely spiritual. We are seeing Shuddha Sattva only, it is possible. But the Lord can take shelter as He desires, as if appearing from a pillar, as if appearing from the semen of Kardama. Like that. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.